So today, if you're going to want to learn the violin, this is the video for you. So today I'm going to tell you what you need to learn the violin and basically teach you to get you off to a level 1 violin. So the first thing you're going to need to do is rent or buy a violin and a shoulder rest. I have a spongy shoulder rest, but you can buy any shoulder rest compatible for the violin. Then you're going to need to buy a book and the Essential Elements for Strings, Violin Book 1. You can find this at any local music store or Amazon.com, honestly, so yeah. You can do, you have sheet music. You should print out violin scales, like... So the first thing you're going to learn is pizzicatoing, which is where you put your thumb on under the fingerboard and then you pluck strings. So yeah, and then the same thing with the bow. So you hold the bow like this. The bow like this. So you put your thumb under that little arch. You put index finger on this little pad, then two fingers resting, then you relax your pinky, but don't put your pinky on this little metal thing. And then you can just play the same thing with fingering, like... tuning, that's another big thing. You can buy like a tuner and then just tune it until you like until your violin until your violin, you know, if until the tuner says that your violin is all tuned up. You can also use that for like other instruments like viola, cello, bass. So you're also going to need to learn the names of the strings. Your lowest string is D, then that's G, D, A, and like that. So yeah, the lowest one is G. This sounding one is G. This sounding one is D. This one is A, and this sound is E, like that. We're good now. So yeah, that's what you need to put like on. You're also, so once you pick up this book, what we're going to do is we're going to go through it, so. In the book you can find out about the string care, how to hold it, which you hold it like this, by the way, the same. With your shoulder rest, and then you can reach your fingering. I don't know what that was, but the first page you're going to start is page 4 and 5, and it says pizzicato, which is plucking your string with your thumb under your fingerboard, and then your index finger you also should get fingering tape to know that fingering tape. A lot of beginners have them. I'm a level 2 violin, but like, I'm going to see them. We'll be back for the video, Chris. Okay. So we're going to start with left play open D, which is. Now you're probably thinking, oh, they label it out for you. Well, when you get music like, mm-hmm. like, let's say that. That's the music on one of my pieces. They're not gonna label out all the stuff for you. You're gonna have to start learning it on your own and start really being able to read music, which we'll get to that. So you can do this with, like, you can skip the pizzicato part. You can just go straight to bow and just mad at me, know how to hold your bow, like but this page, you know where it is, so I don't have to really go through it. But the next page is G, which is when we get the fingering. So we'll start with your D string fingering. G on the D string is 3 fingers down. F sharp is 2 fingers down, and E is 1 finger down. So the fingering tapes will tell you. So the first fingering tape is where you put your first finger, and that's where you will do E. That is where you still can pizzicato, but I recommend pizzicatoing, but if you want to skip straight to the bow, there's no way that I can stop you. On the please, though, tells you the fingering, so you should be pretty set with that. When you move on, you'll be moving on to my favorite one, which is hopscotch morning dancing rolling along. When I first started violin, those were my favorites, like, I love hopscotch, it's so fun. I just always thought that was fun, was it just me? Probably. Rolling Along, though, is my second favorite, and can you guess which song it is? But where the ref says, so you learn the pattern of 1 and 2 and 3, 1 and 2 and 3, 1 and 2 and 3, and 4, 1 and 2 and 3. Like, stuff like that. So you can learn, like, that little exercise for rhythm. So those pages really start. And then page 9 is when you start to actually have to learn. So it's not going to label out A on it, on the note. It's going to start just saying 3. Or 0, and then from there you're not gonna see a little bit of that. So I'm gonna play a point for you, which is King Good One Cross. I don't know how to say that. Essential Elements quizzes are supposed to be a little harder for you to really, like, test it, but, yeah, so, like, how is it? Yeah. then you learn how to do A string fingering, D, C sharp, and B. So you start to learn how to do like sort of like that, and scales too. Like you learn scales. So that is when it gets harder. But then it's really starting to get a little complicated at 11, because that's when it finally goes. That's when you start learning a lot more stuff. So now you know six different types of fingering you need to do. But it doesn't get so complicated until yeah. But Song for Christine's the next one on page 12, which was a little bit harder. A lot of people, a lot of teachers, if you get a teacher, will quiz you on Song for Christine, Natalie's Rose, so that's short, and Dreidel. I'm gonna tell you right now that it does not sound like the Dreidel song. Dreidel, Dreidel, Dreidel. I made you out of place. It does not sound like that. Cause Dreidel, Dreidel, Dreidel goes like, I think it is 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. But rock and rap, you don't need to do. That just teaches you those three, 37, 38, and 39, just teach you different rest, down, up, rest, like, stuff like that. 14 and 15, to me, is personally the page that is transitioned. So, yeah. Carolina Breeze is easy. Jingle Bells, and then Old Man Brown Will Have a Farm, of Mozart Melody, which is Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Stuff like that, yeah. Then you move into Matthew's March and Christopher's Tune, which to me is a little hard. It was hard at first, but for the beginners. Then you move into the bowing. That's usually when you're supposed to start bowing, but if you're gonna skip the pizzicato part and just move into full on bowing, that's okay. But if not, then this is it. This is just open stuff, raise and lower, stuff like that. So 16, 17 is bowing. 18, 19 is when it gets harder. And then the essential elements click the D major scale of this. And this is the essential elements click. Starting at 63 is when you no longer have the fingerings. Then you have to really figure it out for yourself, and you should review the note names. Then it will tell you the Let's Read C sharp review. Start review stuff that you previously learned. 20 and 21 is when eighth notes come in, and that's when rhythm rap, and you don't really play much on these two pages, 20 and 21, but they're still important pages to look at, even though you don't play much. You can play it, but not a lot of people do. But for still, I play it. That's when you, 22 and 23 is when you learn, fourth fingering. So, yeah, you're gonna have to go slowly by slowly, But it'd probably be good if you're studying a branch to this tabula. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.